Let's stand up and give the King of Kings and Lord of Lords great praise. Will you do that with me? Hallelujah. We come to bless your name tonight, Lord. Let the heavens open over this city and let your people feel and experience your presence, Lord. We give you all the glory. Amen. It's good to be in the Netherlands tonight and to worship the King of Glory with you. Now, you're the worship team. Sing with me. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. Is no one else like you. You are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands as we lift your holy name. You deserve the glory. Yes, you do, Lord, and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands as we lift your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There's no one else like you. You are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no saints of God, lift it up to him tonight. You are. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. For you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else. There's no one else like him. Some of you have driven long distances to get here. Some of you have even flown in from other countries. Some of you had bad drives today and didn't find a hotel room waiting for you when you got here. But God is still worthy of praise. This weekend very well could change your life. Would that be all right? So let the enemy throw all those things at us. They just fall off of us in the presence of God. And this weekend, even tonight, hold on to God now and go after whatever His Holy Spirit has planned. Do you know that before your name was ever thought of by your mother and father, that God knew exactly what seat you would be sitting in on the, what night is this, the 5th of November? I was going to say the 20th of November. I'm already 2 weeks ahead. But God had a plan for you to be here tonight. And if we will allow Him, the Holy Spirit will bring the perfect plan of the Father into your life tonight and change your life forever. Isn't that an awesome thought? And so let's just let Him have His way, all right? Some of you come from different worship styles than other people. Don't get upset by that when they don't worship like you do. Let's let freedom be in the house of the Lord tonight. Sometimes I shout unto God, and sometimes I'm very quiet. Sometimes I dance a little bit, sometimes I kneel down. Whatever He leads me to do, I want to be free in Him, not bound by religious tradition. We want to be free in the Holy Spirit tonight. Amen. You can be seated. Now, sometimes when we're worshiping and you're sitting down, you might just feel like you would rather stand up. Well, don't wait for me to say that. Just stand up. And sometimes if we're standing and your legs start to get tired, then sit down and nobody will get upset. All right? I believe for every drop of rain that falls, a flower grows. I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone who's gone astray, someone will come and show. He's done for me. Jesus. I believe in his work on the cross, that it accomplished everything for all of the rest of my life. I believe he forgave every sin that I ever committed, past, present, or future. I believe that his power gives me eternal life because I believe in his power, in his name, as he is the Son of God. And I believe he has chosen to come here tonight and to change our lives. And I believe he has already loved you with an everlasting love, just like his word says. And nothing you ever do could ever make him love you more or less than he does right now. And I've never known anyone else like that in my whole life. Because as much as we try, we still love conditionally, don't we? And he's always loved us unconditionally. Not based on how good you are, but based on how good he is. That's why he loves me. That's why he loves you. And so, Father, we receive your love tonight. And I just want you to have your way, Lord. I want you to do whatever you want to do with your people. I want you to come and blow the wind of heaven here in the Netherlands, perhaps like it's never been blown before. Have your way. Thank you for bringing this group of people together. We just lay it all down now. We lay down everything. Do you know this song? Together right now, just close your eyes, and I want you to think back over your life and every time God has met you. Remember the time that he's healed your body. Remember the time when he provided, when there was just no other way you were going to get through the month. Remember the time that he brought your loved one to know him because you were praying for them. Remember when he lifted you up when you were so depressed you didn't think you could go on. There's no other God like this one that I'm talking about tonight. The nations will come and bow down, for you are the name over all names. So I sing your praise. I love you. Your name, Lord. We bless your holy name. Who is there like our God? Our God lives. Our God is a living God. Our God is he who was and is yet to come. We bless you tonight. Lord, let this whole nation be a nation of praise unto your name. The north to the south and the east to the west. Hallelujah. Start a revival in the Netherlands, Lord. Let it sweep throughout Europe. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. You feel him here already? I feel him here. Hallelujah. Praise God. You can be seated again. Is it okay if I take my jacket off? Would you mind? It's really warm up here. And you see, I'm going to South Africa after I leave here, and I've got to wear this jacket again. After this conference, I'm getting on an airplane and going to South Africa and to do 4 concerts down in the Johannesburg area. And then flying back up to London to receive an award from the Gospel Music Association of the United Kingdom. I think it's the award for the bluest shirt worn by a worship leader. I'm only kidding. I'm not worthy of any award because really Jesus Christ is the prize, isn't he? He is the award of our lives. He is really the chief musician. I don't write songs very well, but I hear them pretty well when he sings them to me. And that's why I share those with you, because most of the time they come from heaven. And I'm so glad that I have a brand new Christmas CD that is actually for sale here tonight and during the conference, and it's only been out for about a week now. Some people in the United States have it. Most of them don't even have it yet. So it's called A Worshipful Christmas, and it's available here, and you can take it home with you and buy Christmas presents right here at the conference. It would make a great gift. I feel like God would just have me do a song from that album right now. Would that be okay? I'm going to do it anyway, even if you don't want me to. It's called Your Name. Thank you.
giving glory to your name.
The Bible says that whoever calls on the name of the Lord, what? Shall be saved. You might be looking in from the internet tonight. I know many people from around the world are joining us by the live stream that's taking place. Wherever you're at tonight, you could be sitting in your living room and not really know the name of the Lord personally as your Savior. If you'll just believe in Jesus and call on his name tonight, right now, you can be saved. You can know that you have forgiveness from your sins. You can know that you have eternal life with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You can sit on the lap of the one who created the heavens and the earth. Is that amazing to you? We see, we don't know how big God is, do we? We really worship a God that we don't know very well because he's so big, yet he's so personal. I like to think in the terms of how big God is that in America we have the space shuttle. Are you familiar with the space shuttle over here? It's the fastest vehicle known to man. When it's in orbit, it travels at 17,500 miles per hour. I don't know how many kilometers. Do you have kilometers over here instead of miles? That would be like 37 or 38,000 miles, kilometers per hour. So fast. And yet, to get to the very first star in our galaxy, if you rode on the space shuttle from here, it would take you 162,000 years to get to the first star. How big is God? That's just in our galaxy. The scientists now think there are perhaps a half a billion galaxies in the universe. And that's just the closest star in our galaxy. There are stars in our galaxy that would take millions and millions of years just to get there. And that's just one galaxy. God is so big. And yet he invites us to be his very own children. To be a son of God and a daughter of God, you just have to believe in his son, Jesus, because he is the connection between us and the Father. You can't get to God except through Jesus. It's what he did on the cross that gave me the ability to proclaim his name today here. It's what he did that gave me life, hope, peace. And so that's available to you sitting here tonight, sitting out in your living room or in a hotel room or wherever you might be over the internet. And I just hope that even as we're worshiping together, you'll make the best decision you could ever make in your life. And you'll say, Jesus, be my Lord. Be my Savior. I don't want to lead my life anymore. I want you to lead my life. You who made me know how to run me. He's got a great plan, but we've got to step into his plan and out of our own plan sometimes. We got to get on his road and get off of our road. Amen? Praise God. Well, how many of you have traveled more than an hour to get here? Let me see your hands. Look at almost everyone. How many of you traveled more than 5 hours to get here? Okay, a few. There's Betty from Scotland. Betty, how long did it take you? Did you Can you drive? Or did you fly? You flew. I guess if you drove, you'd have to go way down and around and way up or something. Yeah. Anybody here from England? No one here from England? Anyone here from Germany? Yeah, we have some Germany friends. That's awesome. Belgium, I found some folks from Belgium, yeah. Yeah, that's good. Well, I live in Dallas, Texas, in the United States. It took me, from the time I left the airport at Dallas, it took me 22 hours to get to my hotel room here. I tell you what, you must be special people. Someone came from New Jersey? Hey, America! I want you to know that wherever I could be tonight, I would rather be here than any place else, because this has been on God's calendar and I want to be where He is. Amen? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Need in your life, just present it to Him right now as the Holy Spirit is moving in this room. If you have a sickness in your body, do you know that He took stripes on His back for your healing? Leave it at the cross tonight. The healing power of the Lord is in this room. The wholeness of heaven is here tonight. It'll come upon you as you worship Him in spirit and truth. So worship Him. It'll come upon you as you call on His name. So call on Him. Worship Your name right now. We worship the King of glory in this place right now. You're so very real, Lord. You're so very real. You come to touch Your people right now. Come and touch Your people right now. Hallelujah. Ooh. Jesus. Oh, you're refreshing, Lord. You renew our strength like the eagle as we worship you. David didn't say he restored my soul. He said he restores. I think David was saying that I need his restoration many times in my life, maybe even many times in 1 week. We live in a fallen world. We are hit with the battles of the enemy and the battles of our own mind, battles of other men and women all day long, every day. We need restoration. Some of your strength is gone as you come to this conference. You need the Lord to restore your strength. Some of you are weary and just doing His work, and you need a new vision, a new hope. You need restoration in your heart. Some of you, the enemy has stolen from you, and you need the restoration of God's finances in your life by His riches in Christ Jesus. He comes with gifts of restoration. He restores my soul. Reach out and let Him do it right now. When my journey weighs on me, that's when He restores, gives me more. He restores my soul.
thank you, Lord, even tonight that you're restoring our souls, our bodies, and our spirits. You're healing broken hearts with the soothing salve of the Holy Spirit. You are bringing new vision and new hope. You're bringing new life to old visions that have not yet come to pass. For everything is done in its season and in its time. You are worthy of praise, Most High God, and I praise your name. Thank you for giving me the ability to speak praise to you. The trees, they wave their arms. The birds can sing, chirp, chirp, but you've given mankind the ability to speak and articulate our praise. And we give you the highest praise tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't you love the Lord? Praise God. Let's give him a hand clap. Praise the Lord. Let's stand together, would you? This is the air I breathe. Sing with me. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence living in me. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And desperate for you. You know, as Robin was speaking, the Lord dealt with me on this very issue several months ago. Because I think there are things, hidden things in our lives that we feel like we just need to have in addition to the cross of Christ. And I was having a temptation come to me to do something that I shouldn't do. And the Lord said to me, Terry, that's not who you are. And those words just hit me like one of those arrows that goes into your heart. He said, son, you're the blessed, not the cursed. Those things are something that a cursed man does. He said, Terry, be who you are. And it liberated me. You see, when we have the divine nature of Christ within us, and then we continue to do things that are outside of that nature, we're fighting the will and the nature of God. We're swimming upstream against what He wants to do in our lives. And so as you're standing there tonight, there might be something that you could never admit to anyone else, or it might be anger or greed, jealousy, just besetting things that knock on your door over and over again have become familiar spirits to you. The Lord says to you tonight, that's not who you are. Why are you doing things that are not who you are? You don't need that extra pressure. Lay that down. You see, when Christ died on the cross, He completed every single thing that you will ever need in your life. He can't do it again. He can't die again. He can't give you some power that He hasn't already given you. He said, it is finished. That means He took that ugly sin of anger, or that ugly sin of greed, or sexual sin, thought life, everything. He took that, He became that, and that was crucified at Calvary. So you are under no obligation to live with that thing. You can lay that thing down tonight and never be taunted and haunted by it again. And I think that's what Robin was trying to say. He knows how this was such an encumbersome thing to him. God wants us free. It is for freedom that Christ has made us free. So don't live under that yoke of bondage, that yoke of slavery. Let's be slaves to His grace, slaves to His freedom, slaves to His voice, His calling, His love. Amen? So we sing it again. If there's just something in your life, just come on up here and let somebody agree with you, just to lay that thing down and never have to pick it up again. Because of what Christ has already done. It's not who you are, friends. Don't buy the lie of the enemy that says, you need this too. You need to get angry and let that out because you were hurt when you were little, or your dad treated you a certain way. No, that's not who you are anymore. You have put on Jesus. Now you are of His nature. His blood runs through your bloodstream. You are the healed and not the sick. You're the head and not the tail. You're above and not beneath. You are blessed and not cursed. That's who you really are. That's who God sees you as tonight. And I'm desperate for you. Thank you. be to your name for tonight, Lord. All glory be unto Jesus over these people. All glory to the Lamb. You are the great I Am, Lord. Thank you for your great victory. Once and for all, teach us, Lord, the complete victory of the cross. We don't know you as well as we should. Amen. Well, I'm just going to ask these prayer counselors to remain here. If you have a need in your life of some sort, we'll turn some music on, some worship music in the back. And just feel free to come up and let them agree with you and pray with you tonight, or you can stay around in fellowship. Tomorrow, what time are we starting, Robin? And what's going on tomorrow? I don't even know myself. I'm just the piano player.